I'm Omar Freya. And I'm the founder of Green Worker Cooperatives in the South Bronx.
It's about the fact that we don't have good quality food in the area, that we don't really have jobs that don't kill people in the process. We got plenty of jobs for people who are looking to shorten their lifespan, dangerous jobs, but we don't really have jobs that actually contribute to the health of the community. You know, if you know about a pressure cooker, you know, it's this huge giant pot with a lid on it, and there's a little valve at the top, and you use it when you want to cook beans really fast. Well, our communities are like that little valve on top of the pressure cooker. So the fact that we exist means that, you know, ExxonMobil, all these companies that continue to pollute, and everyone else who continues to do the things that kill people in the long run, they're allowed to continue doing their thing because they always have a dumping ground. You know, so we're that dumping ground, we're that pressure release valve. What I care about is that money stays in my community, that people have a say at work, that a business doesn't kill people in the community that it's located. That's what I care about. Our first cooperative will be a retail warehouse for salvaged building materials, basically a Home Depot for used stuff, and is actually able to put a resource into people's homes, you know, giving people the opportunity to get a cabinet at half of what they would pay for it at Home Depot. And that actually makes home ownership more affordable and starting up a business more affordable.
Ismael,
hey.
¿Cómo está?
Estoy bien. Empezamos por el sábado.
But we're gonna start small with four people. We got more than four people that are interested in it. So we're gonna take them through a training process about how to listen and how to work together, and you know, what does it mean to work together in a business. And then, you know, we watch, you know, the people, you know, see how they do. And the people, you know, after a couple weeks that we feel, all right, these are the ones, these are the gems that we can start with. And those will be the ones that, you know, we start the co-op with.
All right.
I got it. Okay. Cooperatives are accountable to their communities. They don't gas their neighbors. They don't get up and leave town. The profits, the money that's generated by a business that is owned by its workers or it's owned by its consumers, that money stays in the community because the workers stay there in the community, the consumers stay in the community. So there's a much completely different relationship there.
Well, I know of a lot of people who think of the idea of cooperatives as some sort of communist action, and it's anti-capitalist. But why is this not necessarily the anti-capitalist thing to do and just the thing for the community and that sort of thing?
Because what we know of in the United States is a form of business that's dominated by mega corporations that have very little accountability to anybody. And that's seen as freedom. But it's really freedom for the rich, you know, right. Freedom for the very wealthy to do whatever they want. What we're talking about is real freedom, where, you know, democracy becomes about people, you know, right. Everybody really having a say over their own life, which is not a new thing. You know, it exists in other parts of the world, has had great success in parts of Spain and Italy, where they've created, they've remade their whole economy and really were able to turn a region around, an entire region that had gone to hell and high water, that had been forgotten about, very much like the South Bronx had been forgotten about. But they've been able to remake their economy and provide jobs for people in their communities and keep the money in the community and actually give workers a real say, which I think is, you know, critical.
We're all real.